again, you're welcome to the Doctors Making Social Impact YouTube channel. My name is Dr. DRBRYT, as you always known. Now, we are still talking about coronavirus infection as the world is presently on a lockdown due to this particular pandemic, okay? Now, let me begin by saying that I have said before in my past interaction that the one most important rate limiting step to curbing the spread of the coronavirus disease in our environment here in places where the spread is still minimal is our hand washing habit. Okay, now before now we've always known that hand washing is such an important thing, such an important hygiene event, so much so that the World Health Organization actually declared the whole day as hand washing day. All right, in this present video we'll be comparing and then showing you how the both compare, that is washing your hands with soap and under running water and then using the popular sanitizers. All right, now this is quite important, especially at this point in time where community spread, when I say community spread, I mean that people are already amongst us that may have this virus or this disease. They don't necessarily have to have traveled to an area where the disease is endemic or where this disease is heavily present, or they don't have to even have come in contact with somebody they know returned from any of those places. So it appears that amongst us, there are already persons who may be positive. And do not forget that it cannot be written on the forehead that this person is positive or is not positive. Remember that people can go without symptoms even they are positive. It's also recently been found out that even when they are without symptoms or even before they develop symptoms, it does appear that at that particular time that sharing the virus and then get transmitting to other persons it's commoner. All right, so of course we've talked about the role of our hands. It is with our hands that will drop the virus on surfaces, so there are hands that will give it on to other people. Probably we shake hands, embrace it with our hands, that we take carry it and put it on our face, all right, touch our eyes and nose trees, and then probably our ear. And that's when the infection is probably set off, okay? So we'll go straight now to showing you how we are supposed to wash your hands. I know you have seen a lot of videos, you have talked a lot about washing hands, all right, but like I said before, we cannot overtalk it, we cannot oversay it, we cannot overstate it, it cannot be overemphasized the importance of washing your hands. So come along with me, let's just show us how we should wash our hands. All right, so this is the tap. The tap is appropriate, it's proper for what we want. I want to show you, all right. When I say it's appropriate and it's proper, you can see it is elongated and then it is curved. Okay, in such a way that you can wash your hands well without you having to come in contact with it. So to begin with, you could use any kind of soap, a bar soap or a liquid soap. Here I have a bar soap, so I'll be using the bar soap. So first and foremost, you turn on the tap in this manner, and then you take your soap, okay, wet it a little bit so that it forms a lather on you, okay. You are expected to wash your hands for between 40 to 1 minute, alright. So put the soap on your hands in such a manner that you form a good lather, alright, and then drop it like this, then you come back. Your 20 seconds to 1 minute should start counting now. So this is how you should wash your hands. You wash like this and then you wash it between the fingers. Alright? You wash it between the digits, and then you go to the back of the hand and make sure you wash properly like this. Wash your hand like this. You go the other way and make sure you also wash the same way. There are about 8 steps in washing in this hand washing procedure. I hope you'll be counting. I think I've had about 4 now. And then you wash your wrist. Wash your wrist, okay? And then you do this. See what I'm doing? See what I'm doing? This is washing your fingernails at this point. Now let me tell you, this is no time to keep fingernails, alright? Because if you have your nails on, either decorated or fixed, they are not likely to be able to do this very well. And then you do this, and then you do this, and then don't forget to wash the tongue, and then you wash this, and then that will be it, okay? And then you rinse the hand, like this. I don't know if anybody took note of the time, but I'm sure we've done about 40 seconds, as I've said before. Okay, so this is how you should wash your hands. Practice it, do it all the time. Coronavirus will come and go, hand washing should remain. All right, thank you. Okay, so that's that. Now, it's important that you take note. We'll finish washing your hands, all right? My hands are washed now, but we're not going to leave this tap running just like that. So you need to turn it off. Now, the catch is, it is common place for you to forgetfully or carelessly don't go back and turn off the tap, the knob of the tap, and then by the way, if you do that, you'd have succeeded in picking again the virus that you probably dropped there before you started washing your hands. So you get your tissue in this manner, and then you dry your hands like this. All right? Okay, so after drying your hands, you use this same thing, and then shut this up, and properly discard. All right, so that's that for our hand washing. I said at the beginning of the video that the purpose was to compare hand washing with the use of hand sanitizers. Do not forget that hand washing will usually come topmost, it's first. It's better than any of these things, but there will be conditions where you can't, when it's not convenient for you to have a tap like this and running water in probably certain places in the offices. For example, those who are at the front desks are not likely to have access to this. So when that happens, the hand sanitizer will usually come to the rescue, all right? But what I've noticed is that people use the hand sanitizer very so sparingly that you wonder if they think that it is the smell of this of the chemical that kills the organism. All right, so what we see most times is that you see somebody just sparingly barely putting something on your palm, and then if you try this, you see you barely can even go around the whole of your hand. So the point I want to make here is when we use hand sanitizer, we should use it without restriction. Okay, if you say you are bathing with it, so be it. And then you also do the same thing, exactly all the things that you did during the hand washing are things you also would do. Okay, so you do this, all right, your hand sanitizer, you rub your hand with sanitizer in this way, you go in between your fingers, all right, you come to the palm, to the back of the hand rather, on this side, and then you do the same on this side, okay, you rub it on the wrist, you rub it on this wrist, you do this, you do this, don't forget to always do this also. All right, so this is how I expect you to also use the hand sanitizer. Remember I said earlier that this is no time to keep nails, let your nails be cut short. Okay, so I hope you have learned a thing or two from this video that I have made. I know that depending on where you are now, but especially for those of us who are around here, a lot of the places are now on lockdown, all right? It is safer to stay at home at this point. I know that the local regulations differ from place to place, but as part of some of the things that I think you should do to stay away from coronavirus infection is that you should stay with the rules that is in your local place, all right? Now, if you have watched this video and you've learned a thing or two, I would like to say that you subscribe to our channel that will be churning out more videos as time goes on. Make sure you share this particular one so more people can see it and learn from it and do the right thing. Because if we stay together and we do the right thing individually, it is then that it is most likely that we'll be able to overcome this surge of the COVID-19.